At a time when China is quashing the rights of the people of Hong Kong by bringing a highly controversial national security bill, the United Kingdom, which in the first place had conditionally handed over Hong Kong to China under the Sino-British Joint Declaration, is nowhere to be seen. The declaration was signed in 1984 between the UK and China, and it states that Hong Kong's previous capitalist system and its way of life would remain unchanged for a period of 50 years until 2047 after the UK withdrew in 1997. After last year's protests against the extradition bill, which had morphed into massive pro-democracy protests, the CCP's red authoritarian regime has come up with a national security bill, which in a sense would hand over responsibility for the security affairs of Hong Kong to China. Through this legislation, Beijing plans to stop mass protests by banning acts of treason, secession, and subversion. But many experts have warned caution that the laws will be used to target critics of the government and threaten civil liberties as well as the city's autonomy. The legislation is also expected to enable Beijing to establish intelligence agencies in Hong Kong to further muzzle any pro-democracy movements. Hong Kong's police force is independent of China, and if the legislation passes, the police will come under Beijing's direct rule, ostensibly allowing the CCP to cull any dissent as it destroys the democratic values that Hong Kong holds so very dear. Although the UK did come out with a meek statement through its Foreign Secretary Dominic Raab that the UK government was mulling on a proposal to give greater visiting rights to certain Hong Kong residents, but this is not enough. The certain Hong Kong residents that Mr. Dominic was referring to in his statement are those Hong Kongers who possess a document known as the British National Overseas Passport, which was granted to residents who registered for it prior to Britain handing the colony back to China in 1997. However, the measure in itself is weak and half-baked, and the Chinese will not be threatened by it. And the tragedy of the whole situation is that it was Britain and the United Nations that were played by the CCP to hand over the sovereign ruling rights of Hong Kong, Kowloon, and the new territories to China. Unlike Donald Trump, Prime Minister Boris Johnson up until now has been uncharacteristically mum on the whole issue. He should have summoned the Chinese envoy by now, who is towing the line of Beijing and threatening the UK with countermeasures if the Tories go with the BNO passport proposal. While the United States tried to approach the United Nations Security Council, Boris Johnson and his government have not shown any keenness on the matter. It will be a major blunder if the UK misses the bus on this one and lets China take control of the wheels of Hong Kong. Meanwhile, the US has threatened to revoke Hong Kong's special trade and economic status under which the city is treated as separate from China. Hong Kong is one of the biggest global financial hubs and one of the main reasons why China wants complete control over it. If the US goes ahead with this move, Hong Kong will be treated as part of China. The UK should take cue from Australia. Australia of late has been upping the ante on its fight with China in the wake of the coronavirus pandemic. The UK too should look to take cue from the Kangaroo's manual to counter Chinese influence and start attacking China through diplomatic channels. Australia depends heavily on China for trade, but despite this, the Scott Morrison government has been at the dragon's tail for an international inquiry over China's role in the spread of the COVID-19 virus. China's expansionist policies have only been strengthened during the pandemic. From the South China Sea to India's Ladakh border, China is using the pandemic as an opportune moment to give flight to its skirmishes. It tried to intrude into Indian borders, but when the Indian forces flexed their muscle, the dragon tiptoed away. The lesson from India and Australia for the UK is that all it requires is standing up to the Chinese. The CCP only knows scare tactics, and when it comes to actually slogging in the real battlefield, it cowers away meekly. Britain should summon the Chinese envoy in London and register a solid protest for the sake of the people of Hong Kong. This is for starters. The Britishers should push China to the edge by taking the issue to the international bodies like UNSC and try to force Beijing to shelve the controversial bill. The world community is looking towards Britain to show some assertiveness, and if it does not stand up now, Hong Kong will be ceded to China.